I'm Ross, I'm the Visitor Service Supervisor for Geilston Garden, which is cared for by the National Trust for Scotland. Geilston Garden is on the edge of Cardress, which is in Western Bartonshire. So the garden obviously has many features to it. It's got obviously a fantastic walled garden. You've got your woodland walks which take you down into the rhododendron areas, which take you along the burn, which lets you explore obviously a completely different aspect to the garden as well. It's got a play area for the kids and it's just a great place to explore. The garden is covered by our head gardener, Alison, and also a group of gardeners that look after this and keep the place looking as good as what it does. We've got a visitor service team which obviously welcome you to the garden and make sure that you know where to go, what to see and what's happening in that week as well. I love Geilston because it is an escape from reality that lets you come here and explore somewhere that you just didn't know was actually here. Every time that you come to Geilston, you'll always find something different in the garden, whether that be that obviously a new area is flowered and grown, or the gardeners are doing something in the veg garden. There's so many aspects to it that you'll see something different every time you're here.
Malcolm McNeil, gardener at the Geilston Garden.
John Martin, gardener at Geilston Garden.
I love the garden because the tranquility, the wildlife, the birdsong, just the sound of the water. I like the fact that there's just about every month there's some sort of colour. There's seldom no colour in the garden at all through the year. And the way that there's different sections from snowdrops through to daffodils, then the azaleas, herbaceous border. So there's a real seasonal flow in the garden. We try to have a variety of stuff for interest. A range of produce, yeah. Potatoes, lots of soft fruit, black, white and red currants.
Like all different brassicas, so like kale, what else we've got, cabbage.
It's not a market garden in any way, you know, it's ideas for people.
Yeah, it's just to let people see how to grow.
What you can do, if we can do it, they can do it.
Well, I love a garden because, well, with the team in the garden, they're just superb. We've got a great head gardener, we've got a great gardening team, and we've got a great team of volunteers. There's always something to do, you're always busy, the day flies in. It's just such, so much variety of things. It's just such a lovely place to work.
The orchard is about six different varieties of apples in the orchard. It is, generally speaking, every second year is a really good crop. We sell the apples when they're harvested. We've started to leave wild bits between the trees to encourage more wildlife, insects and such like in there.
It's just a little bit of tranquility away from the road. It's just such a beautiful place. Like, there's a wee different thing around every corner, like the wee twisty burn, you know, it's just so nice for people to visit.
My name's Lorna. I'm a visitor services assistant here at Geilston Garden. I think a lot of people that come to Geilston don't know what's here. They don't realise the space that we have here. It's a much bigger garden than you realise. Visitors tell me that it's a place that they can come to get away. That it's a place where it's constantly changing with the seasons. Obviously we have all our produce in the kitchen garden, and then in the spring, the azaleas, the rhododendrons, the colours, the smells. I love this place because it's a hidden gem. There's so many parts to this garden and it's always changing. It's beautiful all times of the year.
My name's Nicole and I'm a visitor service assistant at Geilston Garden in Cardross. I've been coming here from a little girl and every day there is something new and something different to see and do. There's parts of the garden that I've never seen until now, even though I've been coming here for years as a child. So the garden really is, it's somewhere special that it's constantly changing and evolving and it's something different every day. There's something for everyone here that no matter who you are, what you're into, you can always find something about the garden that you'd really like.